Welcome to WatchGuard Security Byte. I'm Corey Nachreiner. Today's story is February 2019, Patch Tuesday. As you likely know by now, the second Tuesday of every month is both Microsoft and Adobe Patch Tuesday, so today's video is short and simple. If you run Microsoft or Adobe products, go patch. But let's run through all the updates really quickly, first starting with Microsoft. Microsoft released updates for many of their products, fixing over 77 security vulnerabilities in things like all versions of Windows, Internet Explorer and Edge browser, the .NET framework, Exchange server, the Azure SDK for IoT devices, and many other products to boot. I'm not going to go through all of the vulnerabilities, but there are many critical vulnerabilities. For instance, one of the biggest updates is for a vulnerability in an old version of Internet Explorer, a zero-day vulnerability that attackers have been exploiting in the wild to execute any arbitrary code on your computer. It's a great exploit to use for drive-by downloads to install malware. Another pretty big vulnerability is a serious code execution flaw in Microsoft's DHCP server. If a DHCP client can send a specially malformed request to a DHCP server, he could execute code gaining privileges on that DHCP server. The only thing holding this back from being super critical is the fact that DHCP is only exposed on your internal LAN or local area network. Anyways, with 77 flaws, many of them pretty critical, you definitely want to go get Microsoft's updates as soon as you can. Right now, my favorite Microsoft summary post is by GHack, so I'll be sure to have a link to that particular summary in the blog post associated with this video, where you can find more information about all the patches that Microsoft released. Next up is Adobe Patch Day. It's pretty quick and easy. They released updates for Adobe Flash Player and Reader and Acrobat, as well as the Creative Cloud Desktop Program and Cold Fusion. Again, I'm not going to go over any of these flaws in any detail, but do know both the Flash Player and Reader update fix some serious flaws. Those are two popular Adobe programs that many Windows PCs have at the very least. So if you run Reader or Acrobat, you definitely should get those updates as soon as possible. As usual with patches, I encourage you to turn on automatic updates for all your desktop clients, whereas for production servers, you should probably test patches before deploying them. Anyways, that's it for today's story. Thank you for watching.